in Afghanistan. It was January 19th, 2011, right on the Pakistani border in the Friendship Gate. I was out with my platoon, pulling security for some people, and our trucks were probably about 200 meters away. I remember looking over at one of my soldiers. I see his face kind of blank, and I see him trailing something, you know, somebody, and I can see the look on his face, like he wasn't sure what to do. I jumped ahead and saw what he was looking at, and there was a kid, 15-year-old boy, had a suicide vest on. I remember instantly raising my weapon, and before I could even do anything,
one day, I came home and he really wanted to get an ice cream from McDonald's or, you know, something down the street. He really wanted that ice cream. But that day, I did not want him driving. I mean, he did not look okay. He did not look like himself. And he just begged and he fought and he just said, "Let me go. I'm fine. I can drive." I kept fighting it, and finally he pulled his gun out, and at first he was just holding it, and I was like, "What are you doing with that? Put it away. Don't be crazy. This is so stupid." And then finally he was just so mad he put it up to his head. My heart drops. I know he would never ever hurt himself. I know he would never ever hurt me. And the PTS has not affected him in that way, thankfully. I remember looking at him and I was like, "Spencer, don't. I don't know what's going on, what you're doing. Just please, you're scaring me." I said, "You're really, really scaring me." When you're living with someone with PTS, I think it's emotionally draining. You don't really know how each day is going to be. When Spencer does have a bad day, or if he started out having a good day and came home in a bad mood, it makes me feel really bad. Not bad about myself, but just, I wish I could help. You okay?
Yeah.
Call any in?
Oh, no yet.
I help him get his pills in order. Usually we try to do it on Sundays. I don't really remember any of the names of his nighttime meds. I know as a caregiver I should memorize them, but I'd rather not know how much he's taking or what he's taking.
I'm ignoring him.
He would love to be able to fall asleep without relying on a med.
These are my Trexamet, and these are for when I have really, really bad migraines. These are Percocets. I got Ambien here, Minipress, Zoloft, some morphine, Xanaflex, Mirapex, Adderall, Oxycontin here, Trazodone, Valiums, Niaspan, Prilosec. These are just antibiotics that I have. And I've got some testosterone cream and injections that I use in the mornings.
Gotten into your meds ever?
Yeah.
cries, and she's like really wailing away, I have to like, I literally have to hand her off or set her down and walk away, because I get so aggravated because of some things that I've seen and done involving babies and crying. I have a really, really hard time, and I don't want the two of them to connect. I don't want to connect the two while I'm with her. Mm-hmm. I get so overwhelmed to the point where it's like, I feel like I'm gonna puke. And it's just so uncomfortable, and I hate that. Mm-hmm. I really don't want to be like that.
What can I say about Nemo? He's just my very best friend. I met him while I was going through the NICO experience. Service dogs is a modality of treatment that they use there that, for me, has been the best treatment I've ever received. I still don't sleep much, but before him, I was sleeping maybe 1 to 2 hours a night, just plagued with nightmares and paranoia, and since him, you know, I've gotten much better, you know. My family, they all love him because they know how much he's done for me. And I love watching Zoe play with him. It is so much fun. He's an incredible, incredible person. And I do think of him as a person. And I'm just very thankful that I'm lucky enough to have him come into my life.
I fell in love with who he is before everything. And I moved out to North Carolina knowing that he was really ill and who knows what could happen, but I wanted to be there for him. And I knew that he needed me there. Some good has to come to us, you know?
Shelter still so far away.